I think that is a real danger, that that the global order is reduced to potential conflicts between ideologies, ways of life. On the other hand, the wealth that and ways of life that we've now been able to generate are at risk if those efficient production networks break down, those value chains as well, because it's not only material production, it's a production of ideas. And I think there's a very real struggle going on at the moment. I'm not one of the believers in the West that say, oh, the new model is going to be authoritarian capitalism. I've seen the social consequences of this in China and various other countries. And whilst I admire a lot of things that have actually happened in China, there is a huge pressure cooker building up from the very economic elite that all these wonderful developments, economic developments, have created. So I'm a little bit more optimistic than most. And it's based on enlightened self-interest as much as anything else. And I think the one thing that we've shown in the 20th and 21st century is that enlightened self-interest can be a very powerful moderating force, because the consequences of conflict, given the technologies we have, and I'm not thinking nuclear, I'm thinking biological and chemical, of course, but simply to destroy our information systems as much as anything else, such as our dependence now upon networks and computer electronic networks. A simple and successful hacker can bring down a country's energy distribution system. So I'm more optimistic than some.